Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Aziza. I'm reading today for the sign of Leo, for love, a relationship, for the month of March 2024. Thank you so much for being patient for me, with me, after the loss of my son. God bless his soul. I'm back to work. I'm back to take calls also. We're going to talk about love, possibly like no work also, whatever comes in the reading. Speaking about work in the beginning, like, you know, they say here that you have a month ahead of you. In the beginning, it says here there is a business, there is work, there is, like, you know, achievement at work. But it looks to me that, you know, sometimes you rush into making decisions. Do not rush into making decisions. Either about work, especially about love. Because sometimes when you rush into making decisions, you make mistakes. Like, for example, the one you love talk to you in a certain way because they have a really bad mood at this current time. And you just yell at them, snap at them, curse at them, shut the door, block them. They say here, like, no, there is, it's unnecessary. You cannot really do this. It's not really a good thing to do. Be patient, because these decisions, or rushing into decisions, is going to make or give you more problems in the future with this person. Okay, I cancel them from my life. I don't want to see them again. I shut the door. That's it. After a few days, your heart really goes, oh, I miss that person. I shouldn't really done that. You could be mistaken also about your judgment toward this person. Not really, like, you know, exactly what you understood, like, you know, you take it in a wrong way. Speaking about also responsibility here, or a lot of challenges or changes coming in your work. The changes, like, you know, you are lucky, right? But there are changes. You could be really signing agreement. There is a signing of agreement, like, you know, about work, or a paper that you sign. Because you are really going another step, or into another step, or another, like, new direction, or another maybe office in your work, that you will be doing your work, and you will have to be learning maybe a new language, or a few words of a new language. Things that you learned from the past also, like, you know, with the new language is going to help you, because no matter what, I see you lucky. Let's talk about love here. It says here, unfinished business with someone that you love really very much. Someone you know from the past that, you know, you are really waiting on that person to make a lot of changes in your life. And that person hasn't been really doing anything. They come to you and that person love you. They care for you a lot. He or she could be someone from your past, you know already. And they really waiting for you to change something between you two. Because you want them to change something, and you say they haven't really done anything, and you are upset about it. But that person, in the matter of fact, have been really, like, you know, going back and forth and being mad and angry at you because you did not change something. They want you to leave someone that you are really, like, you know, maybe married to, settle down with. Someone that maybe boyfriend or girlfriend, like, you know, they have been in your life for a long time. That you just sit there, rely on that person, possibly materially. possibly with the living, possibly with something. And since you are in love with them, with this person, and they are in love with you, they want you to make that choice. So you haven't been really making these changes, and you are upset and devastated that this person haven't ever taken you seriously to change something in their relationship. See, you point your finger on that person, but in the matter of fact, they say, well, I'm here, I'm trying. I have been really in your life for a long time. But dear Leo, you haven't been changing something. I want you to leave the other person so we can be together. And you are like, but I don't know if I can rely on you, or you're going to be there for me, or are you serious about really this relationship? This person is really pretty serious, but you are not taking that person seriously. They are devastated because they think that you will not ever marry them, and you're going to really leave them sit in the cold like that, and you are taking it as this person is not serious about you, because they are not really forcing the issue between you and your spouse or someone that you know very well or very much. So right now you have to analyze the situation and look at it from your perspective and the other person's perspective. You cannot look at it from one angle. They hurt me. They did this to me. They didn't do nothing to me, with me, or to make the situation better. No, they are really thinking about you that way. This person is willing to take really charge and action to walk away from other things in their life to change things in your life. But if you don't really take them seriously and leave the other person, they're going to walk away from you completely. So, people, he or she waited forever. They are not going to wait more and spend more years in their life doing nothing. Yes, you have been really pushing this person to do something about it. And they are like, we are together, but you do something about it. That's the other person. All right. You know deep inside your heart, if you check deep within your heart, inside your heart, to see where are the faults and the mistakes, you know already. See your sneaky smile here? You know already that the solution in your hand for this person to be with you. But yet, you know, when they walk away or they lack doing anything with you, you always blame that person. Maybe they are cheating, maybe they are fooling around, maybe, let me look into myself, I don't know. Of course, you want a future. You want to be with this person, and when you see this person apply their jealousy or anything, you become like, you know, looking into yourself, and you separate yourself and isolate because you are afraid of the unknown, afraid of what's going to happen. As much as you want so badly to be with this other person in marriage, relationship, and everything, but when you see it seriously, you pull away and say, let me look into myself because this other person is not serious. Yeah, you want them, but you are really looking into yourself. You love them, and you want them forever to love you without actually you committed to them. And you are like, they are not committed to me. No. This person have been really like, you know, really seeing things about you that get them or end that person to be frustrated and angry with you the whole time, and you are like, oh my God, they are violent, they are gonna kill me, they're gonna hurt me physically, oh my goodness, whatever. No, you get on their nerve a lot because they know your game and you are thinking that they don't. I'm just giving it to you like that. I'm telling you exactly what's going on. Okay. This person have been fair to you. That's what it says. They don't want to be really just an affair. Put yourself in their shoes. If you are a male or female, they don't want to be just an affair. If they make you just an affair, you're going to be upset. Nobody wants that. Some people like that. They don't want to get it anywhere, but not in your situation over here. They will be back no matter what. They adore you. They are into you. You are the one for them. Number one, priority. They don't want anybody else. Yes, you are with someone else. Mm-hmm. Yes, you could be married to someone else and knew it. See? Or in a relationship with someone else. You feel in control, in charge, that you are with someone else, so you don't have to be really like, you know, tortured with the other person. And this is giving you the security, let's put it this way. Leo. This person stepped on you like, you know, many times. They find like, you know, really argument, everything like, you know, and you are like always, oh, you are with someone, you are flirting with someone else. It's like they can sense that you are sabotaging things between you two. So this reading to make you understand yourself, because a lot of you, maybe you don't, a lot of you do. This person is protective over you, does not want you to be with another person. You might look for a new love other than this person. And I see like no love is really around you a lot. But they don't want you to be with another person. Even they get mad at you, snap at you, whatever it is, it's just because they want you to be with them. Okay. Love is coming back. Even if you have a problem or a conflict with this person, they're going to come back, renew the love between you two. Your situation is not changing because you are not changing the situation. You are not leaving the other person in your life. You always sit there, don't change anything, and holding on a third party here for security reasons. And you are really in awe that this person is not taking you seriously. They are. I tell you honestly, they are. But as much as you are hurting the one you are in love with, and they love you too. You are hurting them too. And you feel like, you know, good changes didn't happen. That person is not really always serious. Sometimes they say, I want to marry you. Sometimes they say, no, I don't. Because of their ego in the way, that's why they say, I don't. But as soon as you leave the other person, they will marry you. But you feel like, you know, okay, maybe I will leave the one I'm with right now. But I cannot rely or feeling secure with this person. Maybe they don't have a job. Maybe their job is not the good. They don't have extra money or a home or anything. You feel like, you know, that I am in hell. I see many of you like, you know, in the future, way in the future, not now. You might really shut the door on this person because you don't want to be keeping the same routine over and over because you are tired of it. Many of you is going to continue. But the other person, I tell you, like, you know, they are fed up with their patience, so you need to be careful about that. Best of luck for you, dear Leo. I hope you enjoy the reading, and if you need a private reading, because I'm back to take calls, go to my website first, mysticalaziza.com. Anything that you need is in the description box under this video. Just click on the link. It says my website. You go to reading prices. It's a choice for you to choose either PayPal, Zelle, Venmo, Cash App, or Apple Pay. If you click on the button pay now, it's going to take you to PayPal. So if you don't want to deal with PayPal, choose another method of your payment as comfortable, as much as you feel comfortable with it. But it has to match the same amount on the website. You don't really just pay any actual number you need. No. Okay. After that, you purchase your reading, please give me a call. And my phone number is listed on my website. And thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.